Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. A Henniker man is dead after a fiery crash on Route 202 in his hometown. State police say 52-year-old Todd Goss was speeding in the breakdown lane yesterday afternoon when he suddenly merged into traffic and hit another car. Both vehicles went off the road, but Goss's truck rolled several times, hit a few trees, and then caught fire. Witnesses raced to help before emergency officials arrived.
I just saw a bunch of dirt in the road, and then when I came up closer, I saw smoke coming out of the woods, and I saw a truck on its side.
Goss was pronounced dead at the scene. The driver of the other car, a man from Penacook, was flown to Dartmouth-Hitchcock with serious injuries. There is a growing effort in Canterbury to eliminate the town's police department. Supporters of the effort say they are using the petition as a wake-up call in hopes of pushing the board to have greater oversight of the police department. Board members agree that this is a good time to look at how the department is run, but they oppose getting rid of the local force. Selectmen say they will discuss options, though, including the possibility of hiring a consulting firm and creating a police review committee made up of Canterbury residents. The Carroll County Sheriff's Office is asking for your help in tracking down a man authorities say stole $65,000 from a home in Bartlett. 26-year-old Daniel Lennon is wanted on a felony arrest warrant. He's 6'1", 180 pounds, and is known to frequent the North Conway, Bartlett area. Manchester police are cracking down on panhandlers. Officers issued several citations over the weekend to panhandlers in various parts of the city, including the area of South Willow Street. Police say many people have been complaining that the panhandlers are disrupting traffic and creating safety issues. Panhandling is not a crime in Manchester, but seven people were issued summonses for disorderly conduct. WMUR is giving you another chance to help someone in need. Our annual Spirit of Giving food drive kicks off this Friday, December 11th. We'll be collecting non-perishable food items, including prepackaged donations at all Hannaford, Shaw's, and Walmart locations in New Hampshire through the 13th. All of the food collected will go to the New Hampshire Food Bank. The popular Ice Castle is returning to Lincoln in January. The Hobo Scenic Railroad will once again be the host to Utah-based Ice Castles. If the weather cooperates, organizers hope it will be open through March. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.